my pleasure, along with Secretary Gates, to welcome the Foreign Minister and the Defense Minister to Washington for this Security Consultative Committee meeting, known as the 2+2. For more than 50 years, the alliance between Japan and the United States has been the cornerstone of security in the Asia-Pacific region. Our agenda today, embodied in the documents that we have just released, reflects the breadth and depth of our alliance. We are cooperating more closely on a wider range of issues and challenges than ever before. It has been more than 3 months since the tragic events of March 11th left tens of thousands of people dead or missing and hundreds of thousands homeless. The Japanese people have shown remarkable strength in the face of this unprecedented crisis. All Americans have been proud to stand with you and support your efforts to recover. Today we discussed our country's ongoing work together and reaffirmed our commitment to maintain these efforts for as long as they are needed. We also made important progress on several initiatives that will enhance our ability to defend Japan and respond to a variety of threats to the security of the Asia-Pacific region. For example, we explored ways to broaden and deepen our cooperation on defense technologies. As Secretary Gates will describe, we also took steps to reduce the impact of our defense presence on the communities in Okinawa. We discussed a range of regional and global issues. On North Korea, we remain committed to deterring further provocative behaviors by North Korea, supporting a North-South dialogue, and promoting the complete and peaceful denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula. We talked about our efforts to improve regional cooperation in a variety of multilateral forums and through a trilateral dialogue with India. On global issues, we discussed our joint efforts to advance peace and reconciliation in Afghanistan, ensure Iran's compliance with its obligations under the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty, and bring security against the pirates to the waters off the Horn of Africa. But overall, we really celebrated the mutual respect and shared values that have served us so well for the past 50 years. As the U.S.-Japan alliance enters its second half century, it remains indispensable to the peace, security, and economic dynamism of the Asia-Pacific region. And I was very honored to have this opportunity to host our colleagues and discuss these very important issues together. Minister Matsumoto.
よろしいでしょうか。あの、ぜひ。震災の支援のためにも信頼性の高い日本製の機械を使っていただけたら大変嬉しいと思います。
Also for the purpose of supporting Japan in the aftermath of the earthquake, I hope the U.S. government will be using more of the Japanese equipment.
それでは改めて申し上げたいと思いますが、日米安保条約署名50周年の昨年以来、日米同盟深化のための協議を続けてまいりました。
Well, let me try once again. Since the 50th anniversary of Japan-US Security Treaty last year, we've continued our consultations for the purpose of deepening the Japan-US alliance.
その結果、今日4年ぶりの2プラス2開催に至ったことを大変嬉しく思います。
And I'm very happy to say that as a result of those efforts, we've met today in this 2+2 setting, which takes place for the first time in 4 years.
4年前からは両国とも政権が交代をしているわけでありますが、とりわけ我が国にとっては本格的な政権交代が行われて、初の民主党政権下での2プラス2ということで、大変意義あるものというふうに思っております。
And during these 4 years, there have been change in government in both countries. But especially in Japan, we had a full, what I might call full-fledged change of government, and this was 2+2 held for the first time under a DPJ administration, and for that it is all the more significant.
この間に我が国および地域をめぐる戦略環境は大きく変化をいたしました。
Now, in the intervening years, the strategic environment around Japan and in the region underwent significant change.
我が国は今年3月11日に東日本大震災に見舞われました。
And Japan was struck by the Great East Japan Earthquake on the 11th of March.
この震災にあたっては、米国からいただいた格別の協力に改めてこの場で心から感謝を申し上げます。
And I'd like to take this opportunity to once again express our heartfelt gratitude for the very special cooperation extended to us by the United States in the aftermath of the earthquake.
このような状況の下で、日米の政府はもとより、両国民の理解のもと、日米同盟の重要性が一層高まっているということを改めて皆さんに申し上げたいと思います。
And I'd like to mention to you that under these circumstances, the awareness of the importance of Japan-U.S. alliance has only increased, not just in the two governments, but amongst the peoples of our two countries.
今回の日米安全保障協議委員会では、まず東アジアにおける地域情勢を議論し、地域の安全保障環境は一層不確実なものになってきているという認識を共有いたしました。
And in the 2+2 today, in the Security Consultative Committee meeting today, we first took up the regional situation in East Asia and saw eye to eye that the uncertainties in the security, regional security environment has been increasing.
このような基本認識に立ちつつ、新たな共通の戦略目標を策定いたしました。
And building on that basic understanding, we agreed on a new common strategic objectives.
次に、今後の日米安全保障防衛協力について協議をし、幅広い分野において協力を深化拡大していくことで一致いたしました。
Next, we discussed Japan-U.S. security and defense cooperation in the future, and agreed on deepening and expanding cooperation in broad range of areas.
核を含む拡大抑止協議の定期化、いわゆるグローバルコモンズに関する宇宙サイバーに関する協議の進めることで一致をいたしました。
In addition to regularizing the extended deterrence consultations, including the nuclear, in the area of so-called global commons, we also agreed to have consultations on space and cyber space as well.
また、日米韓や日米豪の三カ国協力など、地域における価値観を共有する国々との協力をさらに進めることでも一致をいたしました。
We also agreed to further advance cooperation with countries that share countries in the region that share values with us in such settings as Japan, U.S., ROK, and Japan, U.S., Australia, trilateral cooperation, etc.
米軍再編については現在の日米合意を推進していくというコミットメントを確認をいたしました。
すみません。何についてAnd also with regard to U.S. forces realignment, that we also reaffirm that we shall continue the consultations of work that has been underway.
米軍再編の目的は抑止力の維持と地元負担の軽減であり、この両立が現在の日米合意であります。
The purpose of the realignment is to maintain deterrence and reduce burdens on local communities, and the agreement this time is to achieve both.
また、事件事故の防止や騒音の問題を含む地元の負担軽減についても緊密に協力をしていくということを確認をいたしました。
Also agreed on.And also we confirmed close cooperation on reducing burdens on local communities, including on issues of on preventing incidents and accidents and reducing and dealing with noise issues.
また今回の日米安全保障協議委員会は幅広い分野において今後の日米安保協力の方向性を示すという極めて重要な成果を上げることができたと思っております。
I also believe that the 2 plus 2 meeting this time managed to come up with very important, extremely important results in setting the direction for future Japan-U.S. security cooperation in a broad range of areas.
今回の共同発表に基づいて日米安保関係をさらに発展をさせていく、日米同盟をさらに進化させていくことに努力をしてまいりたいと思います。
And on the basis of this and joint statement, we'd like to continue to do all our best to further develop in Japan-U.S. security relations and deepen in Japan-U.S. alliance.
最後にホストをしていただいたクリントン長官に心から感謝を申し上げるとともに、退任間際まで日米関係にご尽力をいただいたゲーツ長官にも心からのお礼を申し上げ、また国務省国防省の関係者の方々、そしてルース大使をはじめとする在京の米国の関係者の方々にも心から御礼を申し上げて、今回の日米安全保障協議会の大きな成果を挙げられたことを誇りに思いたいと思います。
I'd like to also express our heartfelt gratitude to Secretary Clinton for hosting us and hosting this 2 plus 2 meeting. I'd also like to express my heartfelt gratitude to Secretary Gates for working very hard for this Japan-US alliance until the very last, very end of his term. And let me also say that we can conclude this 2 plus 2 meeting with pride for the results that we've achieved, thanks to all the efforts that have been made by people concerned at the State Department, Defense Department, Ambassador Roos, and all the others concerned.
一番大切なホワイトハウスの関係者の方々にもお礼を申し上げなければいけないと思います。ありがとうございました。
And, I certainly would have to express my and of course to also express my gratitude to the most important people, the people at the White House. And with that, let me conclude my remarks.
Thank you very much.
We had an excellent discussion today. We focused on the most critical challenges facing the Asia-Pacific region.
素晴らしい議論を行うことができたんですけれども、アジア太平洋地域のいろんな課題について議論いたしました。朝鮮半島の非核化、アフガンの支援、そして海上の安全保障などについて議論いたしました。
We have also agreed on a framework to transfer jointly produced missile defense interceptors to third parties to deepen our cooperation on humanitarian assistance and disaster relief and to start new initiatives in space and cyber security.
また、共同生産をした迎撃機を第三国に移転するための枠組みについて合意をすることができましたし、人道支援、災害対策の協力を深化し、また宇宙とサイバーの分野において新しい取り組みをすることについて合意いたしました。
The sight of U.S. and Japanese forces working side by side to bring aid to the survivors of the earthquake and tsunami in March demonstrated the high level of interoperability between U.S. and Japanese forces.
3月の地震と津波の後にアメリカと日本の部隊が一緒に人々を助けに行っていた姿が日米の部隊の間に存在する総合運用性がよく示されました。
It also validated years of investment by both nations in training and capabilities.
また日米両国が長年訓練そして能力にいろいろと投資をしてきたことがよく確認されました。
It also demonstrated to a new generation in both countries the close bonds between our people and the value of this alliance.
また両国の新しい世代に対して、同盟の価値そして両国の間の非常に強い絆というのも示されました。
As a Pacific power, the U.S. remains committed to maintaining a robust forward presence in East Asia.
太平洋の大国として、合衆国は強い前方展開のプレゼンスを東アジアに継続する意思です。
The decision announced today on the Futenma replacement facility configuration, along with other elements of the 2006 realignment roadmap, shows we are making steady progress toward modernizing U.S. forward presence in the region.
さて、本日の声明で、普天間代替施設の形態、また2006年のロードマップのその他の部分について確認があることによって、日米がアメリカの前方展開プレゼンスを近代化する意味で進展を遂げているということを示しています。
It is critical that we move forward with the relocation of Futenma and construction of facilities in Guam for the U.S. Marines.
普天間の移設及び、アメリカの海兵隊のグアムへの移転のための施設の工事について、これからも前に進めていくことが極めて重要です。
Doing so will reduce the impact of our presence on local residents in Okinawa.While allowing us to maintain capabilities critical to the alliance in Japan.
同盟及び日本にとって不可欠な能力を保ちながら現地の住民へのインパクトを小さくすることを可能にします。
Close on a personal note.
若干個人的な話をさせていただきたいと思います。
After coming to this position in late 2006, one of the most positive changes I saw from my last time in government was an extraordinary improvement in U.S.-Japanese relations.
2006年の最後にこのポストに就いたわけなんですけれども、前回政権に勤めていた時と一つ大きな差があったわけなんですけれども、日米関係が、本当に素晴らしく改善されていたことでした。
Those ties have only grown and deepened in recent years.
近年、このような絆は成長し、より深くなってきました。
I leave this post convinced that the future of our alliance is a bright one that will continue to be the cornerstone of peace and prosperity in the Asia Pacific.
これから退職をいたしますけれども、日米同盟の将来は明るい将来であり、またアジア太平洋地域にの平和と繁栄の礎であり続けることについて確信しながら退職いたします。
Thank you.
ありがとう。
私は2009年の9月に防衛大臣に就任をいたしましたが、4年ぶりの2プラス2の会合に出席でき、またクリントン長官、ゲーツ長官にお会いして、極めて有意義な議論ができましたことを大変嬉しく思っております。
I assumed office as defense minister in September of 2009, and I'm truly happy that I was able to attend this 2 plus 2 meeting that was held for the first time in 4 years, and to engage in very useful exchange of views discussions with Secretary Clinton and Secretary Gates.
特にあの民主党政権になって初めて2プラス2を開催をして防衛面で多くの成果が得られたことは日本の民主主義の成熟度を示すものであり大変意義深いものであると考えております。
And I believe that you know, the fact that this first 2 plus 2 meeting since the inauguration of a DPJ administration in Japanproducing important results in terms of in the area of defense is a reflection of the maturity of Japanese democracy, and in that respect, I think it's been very significant.
この意味を私理由にちょっと解説をさせていただきたいと思いますが、日米同盟の過去50年というものは、日本の国の自民党政権が中心で行われてきました。過半数ではありましたけれども常に、一定の反対勢力そしてまた批判勢力があったわけでありますが今回民主党が政権を獲得して、この2プラス2が開かれたということにおいて日本の政治勢力の 80% 以上がコミットしたということで、次なる50年に向けて大変意義深いものであったというふうに認識をいたしております。
Now, if I may add some commentary in my own way, in the past, the alliance in the past half a century, Liberal Democratic Party continued to play a central role, the opposition, not quite having majority, had voiced their opposition and criticism. Now that DPJ has come into power, we had this first 2 plus 2 under a DPJ administration, and this means that more than 80% of the political forces in Japan are committed to the Japan-US alliance. So I think this is very significant for the next half century of the alliance.
And
let me briefly comment about the 2 plus 2 meeting this time from my position as Defense Minister.
防衛計画の対抗と米軍の体制見直しに言及し、さまざまな分野での安全保障、防衛協力を強化することで一致をいたしました。
We referred to the new defense program guidelines of Japan and the U.S. military transformation and agreed to strengthen security and cooperation, security and defense cooperation in numerous areas.
SM3 Block 2A の第三国移転が認められうる基準や協議機関等について合意できたことは大きな成果だったと考えております。
And I think we achieved a very important result by agreeing on the criteria for agreeing to third country transfers of SM3 Block 2A and the consultative mechanism for that purpose.
さらに世界的に国際共同開発生産が進む中防衛装備品の高性能化やコスト削減のため現在日本政府が行っている検討についてはこれを促進し米国政府もその努力を奨励することとなりました。
Now, the government of Japan is currently engaged in a study for the in order to deal with increasing sophistication of defense equipment and reducing costs involvedagainst the backdrop of increasing trends for international co-development and production. On this, we agreed to further promote such efforts, and the U.S. government will encourage this, such efforts.
普天間飛行場の移設問題については、滑走路の形状を V 字型に決定をいたしました。で、これは移設に向けた重要な進展であると考えております。また2014年の 完成目標は外すことといたしましたが、普天間飛行場の固定化を避けるため、できるだけ早い時期に移転を完了することを確認をいたしました。
We also decided on the V-shaped configuration for the runways in connection with the 普天間 relocation issue, and I think this is a very important progress towards the relocation of the facilities. We decided to remove the deadline of 2014 for its completion, but in order to avoid the continued use of FDEM Air Station, we also confirmed that we shall strive for earliest possible relocation.
最後に、私から東日本大震災に際しての米国からの多大な支援と米国の優しさに改めて感謝を申し上げ、友達作戦に対し日本人が感謝し勇気を与えられたということを申し上げました。
I also took the opportunity to express once again our heartfelt gratitude for the very generous support given by the United States in the aftermath of the Great East Japan earthquake, and for the kindness extended, and mentioned that the entire Japanese are grateful for the Operation Tomodachi and have been greatly encouraged by that.
さらに今回の震災から学び、状況の変化に適応していくことが重要であるということでありまして、例えば災害救援の後方支援の拠点を設置することや、ロボットや無人機のような最新の技術を活用して日米間で議論していくことは極めて重要であると考えており、このことを議論の中で十分にご説明を申し上げ、賛同を得たことは大変嬉しく思っております。
I believe it will be very important for us to learn from the experience of the earthquake and adapt to changing circumstances. I believe it will be very extremely important for Japan and the United States to engage in discussions on various matters, including the idea of establishing a logistic hub for disaster relief. And for the utilization of leading-edge technologies such as robots and UAVs. I explained this idea, and the U.S. side concurred, which is, I'm very happy about that.
今回の震災では、沖縄に所在しております海兵隊をはじめ、米軍が日本に駐留する意義、そして安心感が改めて示されたところであり、今回の2プラス2の成果と相まって、両国の絆をさらに強固なものとし、同盟を進化、発展、させていくべく努力をしてまいりたいと思っております。
The, in the aftermath of the earthquake, understanding of the significance of the stationing of U.S. forces in Japan, including the Marine Corps in Okinawa,I believe has been understood that has brought a greater sense of security to the Japanese people. And building on the results of the 2 plus 2 meeting this time, I would like to continue to strive to further cement the ties that we have, the close ties we have between our two countries, and further deepen and advance our alliance.
最後に、先ほどゲッチ長官から個人的な見解が述べられましたが、私からも申し述べたいという思いますので、お許しをいただきたいと思います。
Lastly, well, since Secretary Gates said towards his end of his remarks, he spoke on a personal note, let me also reciprocate by speaking on a personal note.
今回で、ゲーツ長官との会談は最後となりますが、今回で、私は7回、会談をいたしました。去りゆく長官に惜しみない拍手を送ると同時に、今後も卓越した能力をぜひ民間の立場で発揮していただき、できるならばシャングリラの会議で 長官が常にご出席いただければ大変嬉しいと思い、今日までの大きな貢献にエールを送って私の言葉とさせていただきます。
Well, this will be my last meeting with Secretary Gates, but this also happened to be the seventh meeting that I've had with him over the years. I would like to send a very warm applause to him as he leaves the stage, wishing that he would continue to apply his outstanding capability in the private sector, and if at all possible, I hope that he will be a regular attendant participant at the Shangri-La Dialogue in the future as well. So let me conclude by expressing my heartfelt gratitude for the very significant contributions that he has made to date.
Unfortunately, given that we have consecutive translation today, we only have time for one question from the American side and one question from the Japanese side. From the American side, Jill Doherty, CNN, please.
Thank you very much. Madam Secretary, Secretary Gates says that the start of any drawdown in Afghanistan should be modest. Others, of course, think that it should be much speedier. What is your view on this, and which scenario would make it easier for the State Department personnel, USAID, other civilians in Afghanistan to carry out their mission? And just a quick question on another subject, the Saudi women drivers protest. We were told yesterday that you are engaged in quiet diplomacy. Some people think that it's a little bit too quiet. And they would say that perhaps the reason you're doing that is because you do not want to offend the Saudi government at a time when the United States really needs it, especially in the Mideast. Can you explain your views on that? And Secretary Gates, if I could, you say that the drawdown has to be politically credible here at home. Could you explain a little bit more what you meant by that? Because, of course, it could be open to interpretation that political considerations are driving this rather than the situation on the ground. Thank you.
Well, Jill, let me start with respect to Afghanistan, and I think you would expect me to say that I will not have any comment before the President delivers the speech that he intends to make. The time for it has not yet been set, but we expect it will be occurring soon. In fact, Secretary Gates and I will be leaving here to go to the White House for further consultations with the President. And then I am scheduled to testify on Thursday before the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. And I'm sure, since the subject of the hearing is Afghanistan and Pakistan, I will have quite a bit to say and a lot of questions to answer. So at that time, I will certainly respond to your concerns that you raised in the question. With respect to Saudi Arabia and the ban on women driving, let me start by saying that this is about Saudi women themselves. They have joined together. They are acting on behalf of their own rights. This is not about the United States. It is about the women of Saudi Arabia. And what these women are doing is brave, and what they are seeking is right. But the effort belongs to them. I am moved by it, and I support them. But I want to underscore the fact that this is not coming from outside of their country. This is the women themselves seeking to be recognized. And we have raised this issue at the highest level of the Saudi government. We've made clear our views that women everywhere, including women in the kingdom, have the right to make decisions about their lives and their futures. They have the right to contribute to society and provide for their children and their families. And mobility, such as provided by the freedom to drive, provides access to economic opportunity, including jobs, which does fuel growth and stability. And it's also important for just day-to-day life, to say nothing of the necessity from time to time to transport children for various needs and sometimes even emergencies. Now, I know there is an active debate in Saudi Arabia on a range of social issues. For our part, we will continue in private and in public to urge all governments to address issues of discrimination and to ensure that women have the equal opportunity to fulfill their own God-given potential. But I want to again underscore and emphasize that this is not about the United States. It's not about what any of us on the outside say. It is about the women themselves and their right to raise their concerns with their own government.
With respect to the political credibility of the president's decision, it simply was first of all, it was intended to be open to interpretation. And second, the president has to take into account on any national security issue sustainability here at home, both among the public and in the Congress. And it goes without saying that there are a lot of reservations in the Congress about the war in Afghanistan and our level of commitment. There are concerns among the American people who are tired of a decade of war. So the president obviously has to take those matters into consideration as well as the conditions on the ground in Afghanistan in making his decision.
Last question, Mr. Sagaguchi, Mainichi Shimbun.
I'd like to ask of both Minister Kitazawa and Secretary Gates about Futenma relocation and U.S. forces realignment. Following the inauguration of the DPJ administration, there was some confusion regarding the U.S. Forces realignment, whereas now the situation has really returned to understanding the agreement under the LDP-Cometo coalition government. So what do you think of this whole process that has led to the current situation? As for the Futenma relocation issue, there is now some voice in the U.S. Congress seeking revisiting the Futenma relocation agreement itself in view of the fiscal pressures. Would there be a possibility for the two governments to reconsider their Futenma understanding?
では、私の方から先に、お答えいたします。民主党政権になって、前政権の案に回帰したとこういうふうにおっしゃいましたが、これは我々は新しい政権、我が国の政治の中では特筆すべき大きな事案でありましたから、これはしっかり前政権の下で行われた日米合意について検証をし、さまざまな検討を行った結果、今日先ほど申し上げたような施設の位置配置、それから広報について合意したわけでありまして、これがもし、時間のロスだという論評があるとすれば、それは政権交代に基づく民主主義のコストだというふうに理解をいたしております。それからこの件については、沖縄の意見が極めて厳しいものもありますから、中山知事はじめ、地元の皆さんの理解を得るための最大限の努力をしていくことを先ほども 確認をいたしたところであります。要はこの米軍再編はの目的は抑止力の維持とそれから地元負担の軽減であるわけでありまして、これを2つを両立するためのために現在の日米合意があると考えておりますので、今後とも引き続き最大の努力をしてまいりたいというふうに思っております。
Well, let me start first. The suggestion, I think, was that under the DPG administration, we've simply returned to the proposal that was being worked on by the previous government. In the overall Japanese politics, this issue has been regarded, is regarded as a major issue that needs to be dealt with. And therefore, when the DPJ administration came in, we looked into this Japan-U.S. government agreement established by the previous administration. We looked into it and studied very carefully and studied from various angles. And as a result, we have arrived at today's agreement on the configuration at this candidate site. Now, if you suggest that this has been a loss of time, I would say this is a cost that entails democracy as we have a change of government under democracy. Now, opinions in Okinawa are very harsh, and we confirmed in our meeting today that we in Japan will do our make our best efforts to try and get the understanding from Governor Nakajima of Okinawa and the local people there. Now, the purpose of U.S. realignment, as I mentioned earlier, is to maintain deterrence and to reduce local impact, the local burden. So we will be working on U.S. Forces, the Japan-U.S. agreement, achieve the Japan-U.S. agreement in order to achieve both objectives. And to that end, let me say that we'll continue to make our maximum efforts.
Secretary Clinton and I both informed our colleagues this morning that the letter from Senators Webb and Levin about the realignment is really a manifestation of growing congressional impatience with the lack of progress.
先ほど同僚に伝えましたけれども、ウェブ・レビン上院議員の手紙が議会において進展があまりにも遅いということで不満であるということの表れだというふうな説明をいたしました。
We both reaffirmed the U.S. government's commitment to the 2006 realignment plan, but at the same time emphasized the importance of concrete progress over the course of the next year.
我々2人ともが2006年の日米の再編ロードマップの重要性を確認しました。合わせてこれから1年間において具体的な進展を遂げることは重要であるということも強調いたしました。
Thank you all very much.